As the former Hammond City prosecutor, I can tell you John Watts is the change we need now. I was a fellow assistant district attorney with John Watts 30 years ago. I've known him ever since then. He would be a very good judge and a very fair judge. On November 3rd, remember to go out and vote for John Watts for Hammond City Court.
Well, it's a red letter day here at Hammond Police Headquarters, where two Hammond men are in custody, having been arrested in connection with recent shootings. We have Police Chief Edwin Bergeron. And you know, Hammond's not the kind of town in which you expect to be walking down the street or at a park and get shot. So I guess you're happy to clear some of these cases.
We definitely are. I'm going to tell you, this is something that we've been dealing with. It's been a spike in a couple shootings that we have. Some of them have been around parks. I don't think parks are less necessarily the targets. I think these individuals were around parks, and they may have been specific targets in some cases. In some cases, we had a juvenile who was actually struck in the leg, and it was not a, it was by a random bullet. Now, the two people that were arrested, the first one that was arrested yesterday was a Damari Coleman. This was an incident that occurred on October 6th at Mooney Park. This is some people that were exchanging gunfire, and this is where the juvenile was struck in the leg. Our juvenile detectives were involved, our regular detectives, narcotic street crime, I mean, our whole department. But our detectives bureau has been doing just an unbelievable job. But they were able to identify one of the subjects of one of the shooters. They were able to get warrants for his arrest, and he was taken into custody yesterday. And that was for the Mooney Park incident. I will tell you that they do have some suspects that are outstanding. We have some suspects that we're still trying to identify. So if anybody has any information that they could give us on these shootings, they can either call Crime Stoppers and be completely left anonymous, or they can reach out to Detective Regas, who is one of our juvenile detectives. Now today, and this is yesterday we made the arrest on him, today we were able to arrest Mr. Dario Carter. Mr. Dario Carter was involved in a shooting just last week, October 22nd, at Hillock Court. There was some type of fight that broke out. He pulled a gun and he ended up shooting the person that he was fighting with. We were able to, with the assistance of Jeff Landry and the Attorney General's office, we were able to get with the Sheriff's Office and ourselves, and we had a good team. We tracked him down to a certain location just outside the city, and we were able to get him in custody also. And he was charged with attempted second-degree murder, as well as some other charges that went along with that.
So you think these two individuals are connected to one another?
They are not. We have no connection. These two incidences were separate. The only connection that we have is the first arrest that we made, which was Mr. Coleman. He was involved in a shooting approximately 4 months ago around Windrush Apartments. Nobody was struck, but there was an exchange of gunfire, and he was arrested for that also.
So does this clear, or do you think you will have cleared all the shooting incidents in Hammond recently?
No, we still have some more cases to work. We had the one that happened at Orange Street Park, and we're still actively working those. We have videos that we're going through, and we're going to continue to work. But, you know, I can't speak highly enough about our detectives bureau. These guys, they have really worked hard. They have put a lot of effort in, and they've done a lot, you know. And I was questioned at the council meeting about what are we going to do about some of these shootings. Well, this is part of it. This is just a small part of it. The other thing we've done is I've rescheduled some of our administrative people, as well as my narcotics division, my street crimes unit, my detectives. We're working evenings. We got officers on the streets. You know, it's been a big thing of mine since I became the chief that we're just not going to sit in an office. We're not going to sit back and idly stand by while people are committing crimes. We're going to get out there. We're going to do law enforcement. We're going to put people in jail that need to go in jail for doing criminal acts.
Well, we apparently have had an increase in the number of shootings, although maybe it's just better reporting. But in any case, do you have an explanation for why recently it just seems as though we've had more shootings in Hammond?
You know, I think a lot comes from a younger generation. These younger kids, they're more apt to play with weapons. They have a problem with it. They don't throw fists. They throw bullets. And it's unfortunate that it's that way. But it's just not acceptable. It's not going to be acceptable in the city of Hammond. And I know the sheriff's office isn't going to accept it. But, you know, we're not going to allow this to happen. We're not going to let these criminals, whether it be a 16-year-old or an 18-year-old, a 20-year-old or a 60-year-old, we're not going to let criminals victimize our citizens.
So recently, we've also heard about gang activity in Hammond and Ponchatoula. Is any of this related to that?
You know, we have a gang unit that we've been working on that they've been able to label some people and look at things. And, you know, I believe that some of this probably has, touches or has touched the possible some gang activity. But that's all still a work in progress, and we're working on it. But, you know, the best thing that's going on right now is we've really been working hard with the district attorney's office. And Scott Perilou and I have had many conversations. We're working on it. And we're going to make sure that we get the proper prosecution against these people when they commit these crimes.
So you expect more arrests?
Oh, absolutely. We're going to continue to beat the doors down and continue to work hard and continue to do what we need to do to identify the suspects. And when we find those suspects, we're going to put them in jail.
Well, good news recently, you got 10 police cars approved by the city council.
We did, and look, that's great. We have a lot of officers, and something we're very proud of here at Hammond PD, when there's a lot of agencies that are struggling with manpower, this is the first time I can remember, and it may have happened in the past, but we're actually fully maxed out. We are fully staffed, and with us being fully staffed the way that we are, it's so important that we have the proper equipment to be able to give to the officers, whether it be bulletproof vests or vehicles or even radios. That's something else that we're trying to get some purchases on, or the new body cameras that we're expecting to come in. We're so excited about the Axon body cameras. You know, everybody says body cameras, body cameras. Body cameras hold everybody accountable. It holds the officer accountable, but it also holds the citizen accountable. It protects the officer just as much as it protects the citizen, and we're excited about those. So look, getting the cars, look, that's a big step. It's a great step. It's going to take us a while. It'll probably be somewhere around February or March before they're actually be ready and road ready for law enforcement. But we'll get them, and we're going to get them and implement it into the fleet.
What else are you working on?
You know, we're just doing a lot of great things. We have Halloween coming up this coming weekend, and, you know, we're going to have several officers out working overtime and out there protecting the kids. You know, one thing I'd like to say is this Halloween, when people are coming through the city, they're letting their kids jump in and out of cars, and then they stopping in the street, and they blocking it up, and then they moving forward. There's so many kids. We're going to try our best not to allow that to happen this year. Take this as an opportunity. It's going to be beautiful weather. Find a parking spot and walk down the sidewalks with your kids. This in and out the cars and stuff, we're going to do everything we can to stop it, because we don't want somebody to get hurt. We don't want somebody's kid to get hurt. And we just need to be cautious about it and take that time to really enjoy the time with the children.
Well, I know we're not supposed to engage in road rage, but on the other hand, people are not supposed to block public roads.
You know, absolutely. But, you know, Halloween's a different scenario, and it's become the norm where the parent sits in the front seat and just edges forward and lets the kids keep jumping in and out. And we're doing everything we can, and we're going to do everything we can to try to change that norm and try to keep everybody safe.
I'm most proud of being able to put together the most competent staff. From the very top, from my clerk of court, my judicial administrators, the deputy clerks, everyone that works for the court, because I could not do it alone. I'm Judge Grace Bennett Gassaway. I love my job, I have the experience, and I would love your vote on November 3rd.